Thank you so much for coming this evening. So we're going to start up in orbit, and you know, really, this is one of the iconic objects that humans have made, isn't it? The International Space Station.
We both have a shared passion for space, and he obviously has a passion for baking, and we both love making interesting events around science for the general public, combining disciplines that shouldn't normally go together.
And whilst most people think that baking and engineering are two totally separate disciplines, I like to think there's this nice juicy gap in the middle, and that's my sweet spot, that's where I operate, that's my baconeering zone. So I present to you the first ever conclusive comparison between meringue and the Buran tile.
So I'm going to be using baking to explore the engineering behind how we keep astronauts alive in space and how we return them safely to Earth.
Here's my bicarbonate of soda. In it goes, reacts with the heat, a little whisk.
By exploring how we get air into honeycomb, that is the exact same method that we're able to protect against micro-meteorites on the space station, except instead of sugar, we use metal, and we do a metal foam, but it works with exactly the same principle.
I can actually throw this at my honeycomb, and it will not break. And the reason that is happening is because all those air bubbles on the inside mean that it absorbs the impact. This is exactly what we use on the space station.
Niamh and I have been working on a project for around 2 years, so between that and bringing in our ESA guests this evening, that's how baking in space came about.
A few years ago, I participated in the Mars 500 simulation, simulating a round trip to the planet Mars.
So he spent over 500 days in isolation inside. It's more than 500 days. How many days is it?
520.
Yeah, he always reminds me of that.
We'll also be talking about some of the research that Yakult have actually been conducting up in partnership with the Japanese Space Agency on gut microbiota of astronauts in space.
We were asked to eat some pills which were actually made from our flora.
Wow.
So there was some kind of cycle. I don't know if you want to go into the details of that. My role today at the European Space Agency is to facilitate the daily life of the astronauts so that they can focus on their mission, from the space food to going with the astronaut or with their family to Baikonur for the launch campaigns.
I love space. I'm absolutely passionate about it, and I've been involved in a number of space adventures along the way, including a simulated Mars mission in the desert in Utah in January 2017. And when I was there, I realised the importance of food, how it impacts on our sense of morale. It's a really important part of a mission.
Being locked for a year and a half in those sealed modules, the food tends to become really important.
I'm here because I'm working on a project called AirSat-1, which is Ireland's first ever satellite. It's a project being worked on by 16 students from UCD. AirSat is a 2U, which means it's 20 centimetres by 10 centimetres by 10 centimetres.
We've baked it to scale, so it's as close to scale as we can get. We're not expert bakers. We're good at building satellites. We're not good at building cakes.
Yeah, it turns out sponge is not quite as good as aluminium for spacecraft structures. AirSat has three experiments on there from the School of Physics and School of Engineering in UCD. The main payload on board AirSat is a gamma ray detector.
Developing that really specialised skill set in Ireland is going to really push Ireland forward in the whole space sector as a whole. There's a lot of new companies coming up, and I think it's really good that we're using a lot of Irish technology as well.
Delighted that this show has been sponsored by Science Foundation Ireland as one of their Science Week events. It was a big partnership between British Council, Science Foundation Ireland and Isero Ireland, and funded by Yakult. So thanks very much, everybody.
The audience is all going to have tasters, and best of all, they're going to go away with the recipes and knowing how to recreate a little bit of engineering magic at home themselves.